What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to install and use the WorldGuard plugin in Minecraft. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. One of players' biggest fears in a Minecraft server is that all of their hard work goes to waste. Imagine spending hours and hours on builds just for some griefer to come in and destroy it all. For some, something like that could be the deciding factor to stay in your server or not. If you want to be sure your players are safe from attacks, then you're going to want WorldGuard, a Minecraft plugin that adds the ability to create protective regions all around your world. These can be customized to prevent placing blocks, interacting with chests, and so much more. Let's go over how to set up this plugin so that you can protect your world and your players. Visit the WorldGuard bucket page and press Files at the top and find your desired version. Click the download icon and save the jar file to an easily accessible location to use in just a minute. After that, you're going to want to do the exact same thing with the matching version of the WorldEdit plugin. Once you have those, head to your Apex server panel and stop the server. Scroll down to the game file section and make sure that the version you are running is plugin compatible, like Paper or Spigot. And after that, you can enter the FTP file access in the left-hand menu and log in. Find and enter the plugins folder and then press upload in the top left. And on the next page, drag and drop the WorldGuard and WorldEdit jar files into the right-hand side. And once they're 100% uploaded, use your server name at the top of the page to return to the main panel, where you can restart the server. Once you spawn into your server, you can immediately begin using WorldGuard, assuming you have the correct permissions. This means that you either need to be opt or be using a permissions plugin like LuckPerms. To get started, you're going to first want to create a region within your world. To do this, use the /wan command in-game to obtain the WorldEdit axe. From here, you can right and left click the opposite corners of your region to create a square shape. When selecting your region, the height of the corners is also taken into effect. In most cases, server owners will want to provide protection from bedrock up to the sky limit. This can be done by using the /expandvert command, which is instantly going to expand the height. And finally, to create your region, you're going to use the /rg define name command, replacing name with the one that you want. Try to keep the name short but informative, like spawn or shop. By default, a newly created region will be protected from all players modifying or using any blocks within the area. While this is super helpful for server spawns, it might not be the best if you're just creating regions for display purposes. To allow any players to build and interact within the region that you made, you can use this command. In addition to large region flags like pass-through, there are also many smaller flags that you can add to a region. To add a flag, first use the /region name info command and then press the green flags button in the chat window. You can also just use the /region flags name command to open the list directly. This will make a large list appear in your chat, allowing you to modify various flags. Some flags can be set to either allow or deny, while others will need specific information. Using your mouse, you can click to toggle any flags or use the arrows at the bottom to view more pages. Just use this menu to modify the necessary flags and then close the chat window when you're done. Going with what we just went over, here are some notable commands that might come in handy when you're using this plugin. This list will, of course, also be available in our guide of the same name that will be linked down below. So now you know how to install WorldGuard and how to create your first region. These areas are so customizable that there's an option for almost every occasion. WorldGuard and WorldEdit are two of the oldest plugins around, yet their use has continued to grow across all of the years. With all of these options at your fingertips, the best way to get started is truly just to jump into the action and mess around until you find your perfect setup. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.